Sickle cell disease is the name of a group of inherited health conditions that affect the red blood cell. Sickle cell disease is particularly common amongst those of African and Caribbean descent. One of the common myths is that sickle cell disease is contagious. It is not. Sickle cell disease is diagnosed through a blood test. In the UK, we have two screening programs. The first of which is an antenatal screening program, which identifies those unborn children who may develop sickle cell disease. These screening programs allow us to begin treatment for sickle cell disease as early as possible. Sickle cell disease affects the hemoglobin, a special protein found in the red blood cell that carries oxygen from the lungs to the rest of the body. Babies produce a type of hemoglobin called fetal hemoglobin, but at about 3 to 6 months old, they switch to start to produce an adult hemoglobin. People with sickle cell anemia produce a different type of hemoglobin, which is known as sickle hemoglobin or hemoglobin S. This affects the way their red blood cells work. Red blood cells are normally round or donut shaped and are very flexible. This allows them to easily move through all of the blood vessels in the body, carrying oxygen to all of the tissues and keeping them healthy. But sickle hemoglobin can lead to a change in the shape of the red blood cell. They become sickle or crescent shaped, which makes them more rigid and inflexible. These sickle cells struggle to squeeze through the narrow blood vessels. They can get stuck, forming blockages. This can lead to a lack of oxygen to the tissues, which can cause problems of the skin, bone, eyes, kidneys, liver, lungs, and heart. Symptoms of sickle cell disease include pain, an increased risk of serious infection, anemia, where the blood cells cannot carry enough oxygen around the body, which can cause tiredness and breathlessness. Stroke, problems of the skin, bone, eyes, kidneys, liver, lungs, and heart. People with sickle cell disease can develop what are called sickle cell crises. These sickle cell crises are episodes of severe pain that can last for several hours, days, or weeks. People with sickle cell disease need lifelong treatment from specialist healthcare professionals. Treatment for sickle cell disease includes a combination of medication and sometimes blood transfusions. These include penicillin, an antibiotic that helps reduce the risk of infection, hydroxycarbamide, a medication that increases the production of fetal hemoglobin. Additional measures to help manage sickle cell disease include physiotherapy to help manage pain, psychological support to help manage the challenges the sickle cell disease presents. It is also important for people with sickle cell disease to look after their own health using self-care measures. These include drinking plenty of water, staying warm to help prevent painful episodes. When these episodes occur, painkillers such as paracetamol and ibuprofen help manage the pain, making sure patients take their medication as prescribed, regular vaccinations to reduce the risk of getting an infection,